why a dose of reality before community college is a bad thing. Because I certainly don't need to pander to the 1%. They don't need my little pep rally. They're gonna be just fine. Nobody's been a pile of shit their entire life and then turned it around because of the commencement address. Excuse me? Oh, no, it just clicked. So you're saying I can be anything? Oh yeah, that sounds way better than what I was gonna do. I like this guy. Don't you love it when people in school are like, I'm a bad test taker? You mean you're stupid? Oh, you struggle with that part where we find out what you know? No, no, I can totally relate. See, because I'm a brilliant painter, minus my god-awful brushstrokes. Oh, how the masterpiece is crystal up here, but once paint hits canvas, I develop Parkinson's. I apologize if there's a Parkinson's painter here this evening. I assume your best work is in the AM. Probably gets a bit abstract by noon. Hang in there, it gets worse. You ever hear this expression? The worst day of fishing is better than the best day of work. I'll call BS. I've watched The Deadliest Catch on Discovery. I've never once been at work capsized into 40-degree water, watched all my coworkers die. Like, hey, at least we're fucking fishing. Huh? Am I right, criminals? I mean, crew? Yeah, your valedictorian's not on that ship. Unless, of course, he just murdered his wife in Cancun. Then maybe. I don't know. Did Chris Brown beat Rihanna, or did Rihanna get too close while Chris was dancing? I don't know. I wasn't there. What I do know from watching Chris's music videos over and over is this guy loves to jump up and do a roundhouse kick for absolutely no reason at all. Maybe he was just stomping the yard and accidentally caught some of that horrible hairdo. There's no excuse for domestic violence. It sounds like a challenge. I mean, does everything have to be so black and white in this kindergarten country of ours? There's no excuse. What if you come home from a long day at work and your wife has drowned two of your kids? She's about to dunk the third one. Can you run over and pop her then? Unfortunately, no, there's no excuse. Gonna have to let her drown that third one. What if you ask her to DVR the game, but she forgets to record the half-hour show afterwards just in case it goes into overtime? The point is there's a gray area. Yeah. And I'm pretty sure my girlfriend found mine about 2 weeks ago. I asked her to record the game on ESPN, which she did, but not ESPN HD. And then she says, well, at least you still get to watch it. Oh, yeah, yeah, no, I pay extra money so I can watch TV like poor people. I don't even feel bad for cheating on you this weekend. We have a rule in my house. If I'm ashamed, it doesn't count. You gotta plow a 4 to appreciate an 8. That's my mantra. Yeah. I'll come home from a road trip, but you are so beautiful. She's like, oh, you must have been with a pig this weekend. I don't cheat on her. It's a joke. Don't get me wrong, I hate my girlfriend. I hate being in a relationship, but I'm faithful. That's the rule. You want your relationship to work, you have to be faithful. Tiger Woods, Jesse James, they thought they were above that simple rule. They're not. Nobody is. And you can't explain it to women either. Like, my girlfriend be like, oh my goodness, like you really want to hook up with some skank? Whoa. It's not you versus skank, honey. It's you versus every skank. Do you see how the scale shifts in the other direction at that point? It's like she's a mighty Spartan warrior. But there's all these Persian whores that will eventually kill her. She gets the message. Sometimes when I'm out at night and I see a group of women, I like to walk up to them and pretend that I'm a judge at a dog show. And I just go,
third, second, first.
In that order. They love it. They want to be judged. They spend a lot of time getting ready. There's not a girl in here that wouldn't like to go home tonight with a blue ribbon on.
Her friend's like, where did you get that ugly ribbon? Oh, some guy at the bar thought I won. Katie didn't even place. I know, it's crazy.
If I see a really hot chick, I'll grab her by the crotch and the throat and be like, best in show. Little heavy. Should have picked one from the toy group. Big can be beautiful, okay? Just not to me. I find you disgusting. Freshman 15's not a life sentence. I know this is awkward right now for some of us.
He wants us to eat healthy and exercise. What a jerk.
I'm too fat. I'm too fat. I was on a plane recently that was delayed over 3 hours at the gate because they ran out of seatbelt extensions. Yeah. Like they didn't have any more. They were out. Like, we had to wait for an inbound flight of fat people to get their seatbelt extensions to bring over to our flight. Do you even know what seatbelt extensions are? Seatbelts only go this big. Some people need an extra 6.5 feet of nylon to strap in, as if any collision would unwedge them. You ever been on a flight and a bunch of virgin flyers applaud like morons after a successful landing? I always pray that those same people were on the US Airways flight that landed in the Hudson River and they just went, boo! Boo! What is this? It's supposed to be on land, you dick! New York gets all the cool plane crashes. All right, maybe cool's not the right word, but you know what I'm trying to say. I love that the modeling industry gets attacked for being too skinny. Really, America. You're not too big? Is something in your mouth? You know why they say that? The models are too skinny? Because parents are horrible. They can't tell their 16-year-old daughter that she's not really a princess. Well, guess what? I can. If you're 16 years old and you think the only difference between you and Giselle is your waistline and not your busted face, here's some advice. Fill up the Paxil, because life is gonna be really sad. If you're walking around like, well, why am I not a supermodel yet? Who are you even looking at, Seabiscuit? Oh, I wanna be a model. You want me to explain it to you? Let's start with your jawline. That's not gonna sell a lot of makeup in the magazines. But I'm skinny. You are a troll. My advice, have a Twinkie, get real good at math, because life is not gonna be easy for you. I'm sorry if this is your wake-up call, but being an ugly woman is like being a man. You're gonna have to work.
sexist man up here? Okay, look, I got a set of titties.
Of course.
All right, I can be honest with you, okay? I know what I'm talking about, all right? I'm not dazzled by a C cup. You gotta come with some titties, okay? You get me? These boobs. What happened was, my wife wanted me to walk with her over to drop a check off, right? You hate to get me walking. And she's like, honey, come on, let's go drop the check off.
Reporting for action.
Halfway over there, I go, oh my God, we get to see boobs as boobs. This is gonna be awesome. Crap. What I did, for those of y'all that don't understand, I just ruled out any chance of getting to see boobs as boobs. Because I just made my woman aware that I was going to be looking at another woman's chest. Yeah.
I'm on it.
Good. So I went in there, and I had to look from the neck up. First time ever. I'm like, wow, you got eyes. Who knew? Okay. I had no idea, folks. None at all. Okay, she could have a third arm growing out of her head. I would not have noticed the third arm unless it came down and tweaked the nipple. Okay, that's the only way I would have known. I swear to God. So I'm looking at her, right, and interesting. And I had to sneeze, and I had to sneeze up, because if I sneeze down, my woman knows I'm a sneaky bastard like that. I look and check out her boobs on the way up from the sneeze. Okay, come on, special. All right. And so I had to sneeze up. I was like, oh. Don't ever do that, it hurts. I made it through, okay? I did so good. I made it through. We're leaving. Now, let me tell you something about my wife, okay? As well as being my wife, she's also a fellow comedian, and we travel together all the time, okay? So we're together all day long, okay? And a lot of guys have to be a drag. Not me. I love my wife. She's not only my lover, she's also my best friend. And sometimes we have conversations like lovers, other guys have conversations like best friends. I thought we were having a best friend conversation.
Third base coach is doing this shit all the time. I don't know whether to slide or do a line, you know what I'm saying? People are sliding into home head first. Yeah. You're out! Doesn't matter, baby, I'm up now. Yeah. You want to make the game interesting? I tell you this, if you get an LSU umpire, you'll have some fun. You'll be staying home playing crazy. Don't steal home, share it! There must be some sports where they don't do cocaine. You can't take a golfer's coke out of their ass in the first tee going, fart, fart, get out of here! Just sitting around on a little slow cart like, I'm running! And the commentator, he seems to be having problems on the fourth. Why are you talking so low, man? Why are you talking so goddamn low, man? Why are these 300 people walking behind me so goddamn slow? Look in the hole, there might be a snake. Look in the hole! Golf is one of the few sports where a white man can dress like a black man and not look bad, you know what I'm saying? It's a nice thing. It's an incredible thing. You don't need cocaine. There's another way to get real high and really mess your mind up. It's called marathon running. You ever see a marathon runner? They got the same look like. How you doing? I just ran 26 miles. How do you feel? I'm alive! I'm covered in my own shit, but I'm alive! It's really a cheap hire because all it cost you was a pair of goddamn shoes, baby. And you never see a guy hanging out by a track on. My man. You need a pair of Nikes? Try one shoe on. Do this for a while. Mess you up. Yeah, baby. It's the simplest thing to think about cocaine is they had the documentary. They asked a Peruvian Indian chief, they said, Chief, what's cocaine? Right in the camera and said, cocaine? It's our little gift to the white man for what you did to us. You take our land, we give you monkey for your back. Look.
Not enough. Oh, I want to take this time, and I mean this sincerely. This comes from me and everybody involved. But I want to thank everybody for supporting the movie Grandma's Boy. My favorite part, though, is like I didn't have any of the pot smoking scenes, which I was bummed out. But like the guy Dante, who played the drug dealer, he's awesome. That's his name in real life too. That's how lazy we were when we wrote the movie. So we're like, what do we call it? Say, give it his name. But so when you shoot a movie where there's pot in it, you have to. They give you fake pot. You know what I mean? They have to legally. They have to. It's like they didn't. When they made Traffic, they didn't just give them cocaine. Like, oh, you guys shoot this? Hey, here you go, some black tar heroin. Fuck it. Legally, they have to. I'm not saying it's right. So they give my boy Dante a bag of fake pot, and he pulls me aside. He's like, hey, they gave me fake weed. He's like, fuck that shit. He's like, I'm gonna smoke real pot. Then we'll see what happens. Like, I don't even know what that meant. So, when you shoot a movie, you know, they have to do like 15 to 20 takes of a scene. So he's loading up real full bong heads and just ripping it. Literally, yeah. It was so much weed and he didn't really think about it. By day two, he like was like, bro, I can't feel my fucking legs. I've gotta go to hospital. Make monkey drive. I don't know how to read no more. He's fried so hard, it was awesome. I like pot brownies. Pot brownies are fun. Everybody loves pot brownies. But I bring crystal meth cupcakes to a party. Suddenly I'm the weirdo. It's a double standard. I don't have a lot of tips on my act, but here's one of them. If somebody hands you a pot brownie, know how strong it is before you eat it. Just a little tip. Okay, people clapping now.
Somebody hands you one, just eat half of it. Then see, wait like a half hour. Okay, just see how strong it is. Because they're not instant. A lot of people think they are. They'd be like, yeah, nothing's happening. Not working. Not working. I'm literally still fine. Then a half hour later, they're like, there's nothing worse than being violently too high, where it's horrifying. Like, you know that feeling when you get way too high and you have like that inner monologue where you're like, just breathe, man. Just breathe. You're gonna be fine. Everything's gonna be okay, man. Nobody knows you're too high. Just breathe. All right, smile at everybody. Okay, that was the worst thing you could have ever done. They just called the police.
Let's do it again.
insufficient USB gas.
So we're doing it from behind, right? Which was good for me because I couldn't hide the pain in my face. And then she started really getting into it, and she started like backing into me really hard. She's going like, bam, 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 and it really hurt a lot. So I had to say something to her. So I said, hey, take it easy. It's the most polite thing I could think of, you know. I didn't want to say, hey, don't back your snatch into me so hard. You're gonna rip my dick off, you lunatic. And then I came on her back.
Baseball, certainly. Baseball's a strike away from being soccer. Yeah. And if you like soccer, well, welcome to America. See, our country already has entertainment, so watching people chase a ball for 4 hours to end 0-0 is not enjoyable unless, of course, the bleachers collapse and half of Europe dies. Or you're watching that girl from the University of New Mexico. She seems pretty competitive. Remember her? She was yanking people down by the hair, kicking chicks in the pussy. I can only assume her father had a bunch of gambling debt and everything was riding on that game. And she's out there, I'm doing this for you, Pa! Or she really hates Mormons. One or the other. Pretty sure they were playing BYU. Baseball. Nobody wants to watch a pitching battle either. Let's hit the ball deep. Don't worry about your records either. For every superstar that's done steroids, 1 billion AA boys have juiced up. So the playing field is plenty even. We'll put an asterisk next to Barry Bonds' name, sure. As soon as we put one next to Babe Ruth's name. Getting to break records before black people were allowed to play? Excuse me? Where is that asterisk? Why don't people talk about that? To know how many homers the Babe would have hit had CeCe been throwing 92 mile an hour sliders. Yeah, maybe the fat boy would have put the cigar down and quit pointing had Jose been allowed to swim 90 miles to throw him a junk ball. Don't worry if you don't follow. 90 miles is the distance from Key West to Cuba. Jose is a stereotypical name for a Latino ball player, and a junk ball is an impossible pitch to hit yard any place except for the new Yankee Stadium, which is a joke. Is the record books might look a little different had our country not been founded by racists, that's all. And I love that in 2010 you're still not allowed to shit on the founding fathers. Why not? Screw them. They were a bunch of racist fucking pigs with a handful of good ideas. I just hope when they were signing the Declaration of Independence, they shot each other a glance. All men are created equal. You know what we mean. Now give me some hot coffee, boy. At least we're not women. Right, fellas? Jeez. What is that like? Is it horrible? Is it awful to know you're number two? By the way, these aren't my beliefs. It's my observations on the world I live in. If it changes, I'll adjust the material accordingly. Oh. I like it when you try to rationalize it. No, it's great being a woman. Free drinks is worth not having equality. Listen, you're in a great country to be number two, because at least in America, it's close, right? Men are here, women are here. Some countries, it's like this, and house cat is right there. That is a bad country to be a woman in. Don't get lost in a hike there. You'll end up on YouTube without a head, and there's no web redemption for that. We can be a little less PC when it comes to sports, though. Just once, I wanted to hear an announcer go, God, black people are fast. Holy cow, all of them, they're fast. Back to you, Bob. Why don't we say that? We're all the same species, got it. If I'm on a horse track and I see him cramming a Clydesdale in gate three, I'm not gonna put my money on it. I'm gonna bet on the thoroughbred, preferably one from Jamaica. They've got wheels. I don't like Stuart Scott on SportsCenter.
If you don't know who he is, he's a black gentleman that graduated from UNC with almost perfect grades, yet feels the need to talk hip-hop for absolutely no reason at all. While he's calling plays, and he'll be like, booyah! Easy, Stuart. First of all, I have more street cred than you. Second of all, I have HD television and you have one eye. Yeah. It's grossing me out. It's 8 a.m, I'm eating Eggos. I don't want to see Cyclops struggling with a teleprompter. Booyah. Take that to the UK where they embrace ugly people on television. Not here in America, you circus freak. Next time you want to catch passes on the sideline, use your hands. Don't let it come to the body. You learn that in Pop Warner. I'm aware that I could end the joke at the good part. I choose not to.
Let's rock. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Slim Shady Lady, but nice cause I texted Haiti. 90 lady cops in the road and I'm arrested for doing 80. Like Hamlet, all about words, words, words. Divide a hole into thirds, thirds, thirds. I'm a gay sea otter. I blow other dudes out of the water. I'm the man, muffin, diving, muffin, cold and fly like an arctic puffin, puffin. Wacky to baggy, hating other rabbits like I'm Helga Pataki. And I've been rocking this mic before electricity, way back in 1000 BCE. That's before the common era, 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 ah. I can't be stopped, flow so sick that it should be mopped up. Chick's got a Dixie cup, I got a dick full of helium, I'll fuck you up. A boy, a girl, a middle-aged bitch, Botox in the third person. I get the perspective of switch and Botox in the third person. Ooh, just relax, if you wanna know me, here's two facts. I hate catchy choruses and I'm a hypocrite. And I hate a catchy choruses and I'm a hypocrite. Met a girl named Macy. Had sex with her all day, but she was dyslexic, so I ended up doing the YMCA. We ballin' Asian, we bowlin', prostate cancer, semicolon. Find that hole like I'm Stephen Hawking. Atticus Finch, killing mocking. Cry like a child would. You rape my childhood, just scrollin', rollin' your polin' to roly poly olies colon. To relax my mind and take a walk by the clock and I pass the time and rhyme in mathematical time and syntax impacts the intact time and I'm an internet provider. Came from the web like a horny spider. Fucked a girl in an apple orchard, then came inside her. I thought AIDS was a butt virus like conjunction, junction, conjunctivitis. I spit gold bars cause I was molested by my uncle Midas. Gay dads, blow pops, another sucker. Oedipus was the first motherfucker. I hate it, catchy choruses and I'm a hypocrite. Hungry, hungry, hungry. I hate catchy choruses and I'm a hypocrite. We the people of the USA, Jose, we're not talking to USA. We got a border in order to keep you out. It's what my NYU essay is about. Cause we're xenophobic warrior princess molested by my Uncle Sam. Is that incest? I want you to smell my finger. Does my nephew scent still linger? South the queers, north of hell. The queer ones suck and the brown ones smell. We guard the border and we guard it well. But some slip through the cracks of the Liberty Bell. Did I say Liberty? I'm in Taco Paco. Hammer, or let that rock go. Cause in real life Goliath wins. Sells all the silk that the widow spins. One more time. I hate catchy choruses and I'm a hypocrite. Hungry, hungry hypocrite. I hate catchy choruses and I'm a hypocrite. Break it down now. What? Bitches and hoes, pose hoes. Oh, bitches and hoes. Bitches, hoes. Bitches and hoes don't exist because the hoes, no bows, a feminist. Bitches and hoes don't exist because the hoes, no bows, a feminist. Take off your bras and burn them, or you can let me burn them. Take off your bras and burn them. Oh, you can let Bo burn them, burn them. Take off your bras and burn them. You can let me burn them. Take off your bras and burn them, burn them. You can let Bo burn them, burn them.
Wait, once.
said that there's no devil. It's just God when he drinks. No one understands. You ever think then if God drinks, he might get stoned? Look at a platypus. I think you think he might. You think there's God going, okay. Let's take a beaver, okay? Okay. Put on a duck's bill. Hey, I'm God. What are you gonna do? Hey. Okay. He's a mammal, but he lays eggs. Hey, Darwin!
Yeah.
There you go. Because nature does that. Nature has no rules. It has no rules at all. Every time you think there's a rule for nature, it goes, you know, I'm out of here. If we take the planet out of it, we're gone. Nothing. Nature will go. Every spring, every animal has that look in their eyes like, yeah. Flowers like Barry White going, oh, baby, give me your hairy stamen now. That's why your dog looks at you like, listen, man, you got a choice. Okay? I can either hump your leg or leave the house. It's up to you. Your choice. Basically, it's that urge. It's springtime. It's nature crying out, let's party! It's time to go wild and do the dance of love.
It was good, losing the weight, had a good time. I did it because, you know, I got a great wife, and I married way above my level. And when you marry above your level as a man, it's good that you know that. And by the way, I'm not the only one. I'm looking around here. There's a lot of dudes who are lucky to be with me. There's a lot of dudes in here who married way above their level. That's right, girls, I am married. Sorry, pack up your vaginas and go home. Sorry, ladies. None of this sweet crank for you, baby. My wife makes fat jokes and my friends get mad at me. They're like, dude, you should talk to her. She makes crack about your man boobs. You know, your movies. You know, dude. That's just disrespectful, dude. I'm like, bro, I don't care. I have sex with her. It's cool. Ain't that right? That's what I think about it. Yeah, it's great, man. It's awesome.
What's going on?
My friends don't get it, though. They're like, dude, you're so whipped.
Incoming letters.
Yeah. You can either be whipped or you can be hand whipped. You understand? I let things go, man. I let things go. You know? Before we were married, my father gave me some advice. My father, he didn't make it to see the wedding. He cancer took it. But he gave me a piece of advice that served me well. And my sister's here with her fiance. And I feel like honor bound to share with every man out there who's in a relationship or about to get married. And I think it'll serve you well, too. As a man in a relationship, you have a simple choice. You can either be right or you can be happy. Right? You can't be both. Don't even try. Look at these old timers over here. They'll tell you. They're like, I don't care what she says. Don't argue with him. She's right. You don't care. You don't care. And if you don't, you simply don't care. She can tell you some stupid stuff, okay? Okay. Tell you that there's three planets in the solar system and the sun revolves around the earth. Go, really? No idea. What you say on Discovery Channel? I heard about that. Don't correct her. Don't you correct her. You correct her, you'll see how much you really didn't care. You lose. lose out on a lot of stuff, okay? Like our favorite thing, okay? Because Happy's the good place to be on. It's a nice train. It leads to Oral Land, okay? Right? There's no oral on that right train where you had to be right. Ask your woman when you're not here. Ask her later on. Ask her if she'll suck it and be wrong at the same time. Uh-uh. That's never happening, is it, girls? Uh-uh. Not for 1 second. Never gonna happen. Come for it. You don't know what you did. You'll do something, you know, a little bitty, like, you know, she'll be talking to her friend, especially when she's in front of her friend. Little bitty correction. Okay. We're going to the show. We're going to leave around 6. And you can just go up there. Actually, maybe we're leaving at 5:30. You don't know what you just did, do you, fellas? All you young guys do not understand what just happened. Because you're going to be later on that night. You're going to be like, hey, how about a look? You want me, the dumb bitch, to do that, huh? Remember me earlier today when I was the dumb bitch and you had to crank me in front of my friend, you stupid ass? I hate you. Suck it yourself. How about that? You don't even know what happened. You're like, because you had to be right.
Now, the three-year-old is a different story. The three-year-old, here's her deal. She's a three-year-old. That's really it. She's 3 years old. The other day, I got in a fight with her. Whose fault is that? I'm 41, and she's 3. It's always your fault with a three-year-old, always, because they are just what they are. They can't help it. Just tape the windows. It's a fucking hurricane. Just wait. Anytime you're like this with a three-year-old, don't you understand? You're an idiot. That's you being in it. Don't you understand? No, I don't, Dad. I haven't developed enough. You just have to wait. But it was partly her fault, because she wore me down. Let me tell you what happened. It was this horrible, horrible day. It started the night before, because she woke me up all night. Just woke me up every fucking, in just 10 minutes. Just woke me up, just, Dad, with nothing. That's the worst part. Daddy! Whoa, what is it? Oh, fuck you, you got nothing! You bullshit are you!
Ready for pickup?
So now it's the next morning, I'm making breakfast, and I'm gone. I'm insane. I drank too much coffee to overcompensate, and I'm like, I keep having these moments where it's like, and there's nothing there, just nothing. Okay, Jesus. I'm making French toast. She's over there sitting in her little chair, just fucking anger, just pure, she's a little ball of anger. She's like, I want French toast! I'm like,
yeah, that's what I'm making French toast. I'm like, over.
Give me syrup!
Yes.
Cut it for me!
I'm happy to cut it for you. You're not asking nicely, but it's okay. Cut it for you, baby. I love you very much.
Then she's looking at her plate. She's literally going, because she needs to be want something. You know, she didn't. There's nothing logical for her to want, so her brain has to go somewhere crazy. So she's looking at her plate. She goes, I don't know which piece to eat. And I'm still not engaging. I'm like, oh, I know, honey, that's hard. That's really hard. I'll just make a list of pros and cons for every piece, and I'll help you with it later. And I look at her, and she's walking towards me now with the plate just vertical, with syrup fucking going on the floor. She's like, help me! Not help me! And I'm standing there, looking at her. And I love her. And I'm proud of her in a way. Because I know she'll never want for anything. She'll beat the shit out of people. She'll kill people for meat after the apocalypse. She'll be one of those. And then later I'm trying to get them dressed for school, and now the clock's ticking, and I'm like, and I'm trying to put a sweater on her, and it's impossible. The sweater has buttons that just don't exist, and I'm putting my fat fingers in her full of sweat, and I have just tears going down my cheeks. Crazy tears.
I'm not crying. I'm like smiling with tears. Copious. I can't put on a sweater. I really can't do it. And she's going like this. So I give her a Fig Newton just to immobilize her, just to stop it. Because she loves Fig Newtons. I go, here, honey, have a Fig Newton. She goes, they're not called Fig Newtons. They're called Pig Newtons. And I go, no, they're not. They're called Fig Newtons. And right away in my head, I'm like, what are you doing? Why? What is to be gained? What do you care? Pig Newtons, fine, go ahead. Good luck to you, go through life. See what kind of job you can hold down with shit like that clanging around in your head. I don't care, I'll be dead. But for some reason I engaged. No, honey, you're called Fig Newtons. She goes, no, you don't know. You don't know, they're called Pig Newtons. And I feel this rage building inside, just. Because it's not that she's wrong, she's three, she's entitled to be wrong, but it's the fucking arrogance of this kid. No humility, no decent sense of self-doubt. She's not going like, Dad, I think those are Pig Newtons, are you sure that you have it right? She's not saying that, she's not going like, Dad, I'm pretty sure those are Pig Newtons, which would be a little cunty, but acceptable, I could deal with that. She's giving me nothing. Now, you don't know. Those are Pig Newtons. I'm like, really, I don't know. Dude, I'm not even using my memory right now, okay? I'm reading the fucking box that the shit came out of. It says it. Where are you getting your information? How do you fuck with me on this? You're three and I'm 41.
A lot of the young people know what I'm talking about. A lot of young people in the crowd. It's cool to have my own generation in the crowd too. Like anyone, yeah, it's nice. Because we can talk about a lot of the same shit. A lot of times they'll do corporate parties and they'll be old people and they'll be like, talk about World War II and shitting your pants, and I don't have jokes about that. But we have stuff in common, you know? Like, who here, like me, owned the original Nintendo? The original fucking Nintendo. It's the best thing ever. You could never improve on the original Nintendo. They tried to make all this new shit. The only thing that would have made it better is if it fucking worked. That would have helped a little bit. Because you'd be blowing into the thing all day. And only you could fix your own Nintendo for some reason. Your friends would try to do it, you'd be like, that's not how you do it, asshole. You slide it towards the edge and to the right and play easy listening music. There's a book that I shove in here. Where's Stephen King's It? We can't play Super Mario Brothers unless we have Stephen King's It. You know what's sad is there's a few nerds in the audience going, Stephen King's It would be way too big to shove into a Nintendo. Even paperback, you couldn't do that at all. We all had our own ways of fucking keeping our Nintendo working. You go to your friend's house, he'd have like four fucking pencils coming out of it. Don't touch it, it's perfect. After that, I thought that's how you fixed everything, too. It'd be like, why isn't my car starting? This Coke is flat. You cheated on me, you whore. It was, her vagina was broken. So I fixed it. You fixed the vagina. It needs to work out.
Let me tell you about this.
Yes. lose my mind. Me, I'm doing fine. Fucking monster, call me Frankenstein. And Dracula combined on my grind. In my verbal prime, feel optimist rhyme. Got Griselda Blanco coke and no one fucking with these lines. Cause all this shit is a part of my job. Parties the women, the liquor, the music. Living the life you could only imagine. Put it in words and I give it to you kids. But I told them, please don't try this at home. You really will lose it. So don't blame me if my listeners do it.
I'll Let's be go. Giving you a display as a y'all body. Sunroof rolling back, speakers up high. I'll be living in the left lane, closing my eyes. Watch the world from the third person inside. I'll be living in the left lane.
Never looking back with my foot up on the gas. Ain't got no time to react.
I'll be living in the left lane.
Moving too fast, I'm just trying not to crash. It could all end in a flash.
And you'll be living in the left lane.
Let me carefully wing, they calling me Jeremy Lin. Never stare at the rim. You gon' give me the rock, I'ma dribble and carry it in. No comparing to him. Up on the road every day, chugging a bottle of gin. Contact lens, 2020, but you can't see them from under my brim. Do it again, damn. Peace mode, cup full, trees roll. Shit, I'm here to rap, and if you're not, I check that ego. Try to keep it peaceful, but if they be coming at me, bro, I'm rolling up in a tank like I got Grand Theft Auto Chico. A mix of Mick Jagger and Morrison, I'm tall again, pushing the fucking limits till I'm in the crematorium. Cause when the star goes out, it does so in a blaze of glory. Then Mr. Harry Fraud will just bring the chorus in.
I've been living in the left lane as a y'all body. Sunroof rolling back, speakers up high. I'll be living in the left lane, closing my eyes. Watch the world from the third person inside. I've been living in the left lane.
Never looking back with my foot up on the gas. Ain't got no time to react.
I'll be living in the left lane.
Moving too fast, I'm just trying not to crash. It could all end in a flash.
Why you be living in the left lane?
Thank you.
Nothing's that bad if it feels good. So you come back like I knew you would. And we're both wild and the night's young. Enjoy my drug, breathe you into my face numb. Drop it down to that bass drum. I got what you dream about. Nail scratching my back tat. Eyes closed when you scream out and you keep me in with those hips. While my teeth sinking those lips. While your body's giving me life. And you suffocating my kiss. Then you said
I want you forever. Ain't no way we're not together. Scars on my body so I can take you wherever. Like I want you forever. Even when we're not together. Scars on my body I can look at you and never get.
Am I out of my head? Am I out of my mind? If you only knew the bad things I like. Don't think that I can't explain it. What can I say? It's complicated. Don't matter what you say.
And I love the way that your breath loves me like Novocaine. And we are always high. Keep it strange. Okay, yeah, I'm insane. But you're the same. Let me paint the picture. On the couch by the kitchen. Ain't nothing but your heels on. Losing our religion. You're my pretty little fiction. And I'm that voice inside your head that keeps telling you to listen to all the bad things I say and you said.
I want you forever. Ain't no memory. Scars on my body so I can take you wherever, like
I want you forever,
even when we're not together. Scars on my body, I can look at you and never get.
Am I out of my head? Am I out of my mind? If you only knew the bad things I like. Don't think that I can explain it. What can I say? It's complicated.
flip on that thing, it's like a villa. So much heat, she can roast a marshmallow. She get cheese from the fellas with the jello. She can juggle that, make a poor man pat his pockets when he's struggling. With two hands, she's smuggling. You couldn't palm it with the biggest hand. Then when she dance like midgets wrestling in her pants. And her back in, acting like you smack it in a track again. Yeah, she is, without even her asking. Feel like a pervert, trying to make eye contact. I can't bear on her skirt. Dang.
I like a girl with a big booty. She like to back it up and give it to me. She stands still and then keep moving. Like that.
What you do? What you do?
I like girls like that.
Like that.
I like girls like that.
Like that.
I like girls like that.
Like that.
Turn around and do the no head clap right. Bitch, stop playing real niggas on deck. So bounce both ass cheeks like a bad check. Go to church, pay her tithes, praise the Lord, cause she blessed. But when she on the floor, she dance like she having sex. Whoa, holy moly, do it like you know me. Make that ass go dumb, word to my nigga Fody. You say about it, you know we in the show me. I ain't never been a trick, but your body worth a roadie. My new chick from Texas, butt big like Precious. I floss her in public, a stunt on my exes. She bring her BFF, we eat her for breakfast. I like girls, see, that's just my preference. Put your number in my iPhone if you're free. Play your cards right, I probably bite your booty meat. I like a girl with a big booty. She like to back it up and give it to me. She stands still and then keep moving.
Like that.
Like that.
What you do? What you do?
I like girls like that.
Like that.
I like girls like that.
Like that.
I like girls like that.
Like that.
Turn around and do the no hand clap right.
Okay. No hands, she ain't using no hands. Oh. Got a turd cutter on her. Strip club, I'm wishing I'm the owner. Coming every night with a bitch full of cheer. Came in by yourself, it's kind of unique and weird. Know you got friends, know you got kids. If you need tears, know you got cribs. Plus you got a cute baby face and a grown woman body. Got a taste all the good, got a mighty. Got a good team, need a new coach. Know what I mean, come on for that choke. What I seen with the stream, but I ass so bad. Nothing but a tease, but I like it like that.
A girl with a big booty. She like to back it up and give it to me. She stands still and then keep moving.
Like that.
Like that.
What you do? What you do?
I like girls like that.
Like that.
I like girls like that.
Like that.
I like girls like that.
Like that.
Turn around and do the no hand clap right.
Everything looks good when you're wavy. The way she moving like she wanna make a baby. Get a little closer if you can't see. What they like when you front, I'm on KC.
Pick him off the panic, a little manic, cause I gotta be frantic. I'm a gentleman, cause I'm an oddity. Got all the track, look
Should fear. everything about me, but you don't, now you just doubt me. That's alright, cause it just fuels me to expand without a boundary. And you'll never be completely safe, you'll never ever be secure. Now boy, this is my business, best believe I'm that entrepreneur. My flow is black and white, I'm official and I'm in uniform. Your skills are as real as some fairies, dragons, and some unicorns. And I'm trying to show you what's real, cause if I look close, you got mad flaws. Not following your damn rules, man, fuck you, I just go hard. There's no laws, and I show y'all that I'm TBE, I make jaws fall. And I'm telling you, stop sleeping on me, I swear to you, I got pro balls.
I don't even wait. And when you're a star, they let you do it. You can do anything. Grab them by the
Donald J. Trump is calling for a total and complete shutdown of Muslims entering the United States until our country's representatives can figure out what the hell is going on. They're bringing drugs, they're bringing crime, they're rapists, and some, I assume, are good people.
Dear Trump, there ain't no other way that I can say this. The whole world knows that you're a liar and a racist. The fire in the pavement, satire, imitation. If you're someone from your past, build a dire reputation. All your views on things where you lie on immigration. You want to build a wall and just divide us as a nation. Riots in the states, all these trials, tribulations. You're a front runner. Honestly surprised you even made it. That's no compliment. That just proves our country got no common sense. Voting for this man who take this nation and demolish it. A man who never knew the closest thing about the politics. Donald J. Trump, the man who really needs to call it quits. All the things that come out your mouth, it's all crazy. Like Mexicans are rapists and murdering people daily. All the Mexicans that when it came up to the states were just families looking for better life, better safety. But of course, you don't know about the struggle of trying to get a dollar. You had the richest father, small loan of $1 million. I need to get this point granted through you. You never worked in your life, it's just like everything was handed to you. You act a fool and you're just playing it through. It's full-blown destruction is what you're aiming to do. And some pretty bad groups are loving and praying for you. See if the KKK supports you, what's that say about you? You got a twist of Donald. There's a lot of things you're missing, Donald. See, this is real life. This ain't a science fiction novel. If you're elected, we'll be gone in a week. Bombs in the streets. Right when we're trying to make peace, it's disappointing. I wouldn't be surprised if you brought war. By the way, America, I expected a lot more. Voting for a man who's really rich and acting hardcore when he's the one that's trashing up everything that we fought for. But wait, yo, I got more. Yeah, you want an encore? Trump's a known abuser too. That one he was caught for. You claim you started from the bottom having a fight when you never paid a single freaking tax in your life. Facts on a mic. You always lived a lavish life. So don't say you struggle. You don't understand what it's like. Yo, what's wrong? You need a tissue? Getting sick of people always pointing out your issues. Look, I don't know how to put this, I'll say it bluntly. You want to evacuate all Muslims out of the country because of terrorists? Come on, Trump, you know that that's some dumb ish. And then it raises a stereotypical, well, then what is? Just get your campaign and vest into a halt. Because now you advocating sexual assault? Now that's evil. Come on, people, you need to stop. You need to wake up and realize with Trump, we gonna make America hate again.
Down. Lifted on the beat, about to murder it now.
time. So many cameras, they flashing. I never glance at them, lost inside of a land full of thoughts while watching this dancer. I'm wondering to myself if she's got some booty enhancer. Either way, I feel the deep inclination to put my hands on her. I'm a modern day Galileo who lives in Atlanta, the capital of the ratchets, aristocrats, and traffickers. A practitioner, practice until I master it. Passionate by my adjective syllables, so elaborate. Anything less to describe me is just inaccurate. You're a student of classes in which I am a graduate. Immaculate vernacular, Batmobile like Dracula. Giving these boys the blues while telling these hoes to saddle up. You catching feelings, I think you squarer than Madison. I'm in my zone, ain't no way I'll ever snap out of it.
Shot 'cause the bar's hot and it's coming from a young white boy. I just laugh at it.
looking around and I see what's around me. I ain't even trying to throw no shade. Everybody asking me to work, but every single time I tell them no way. They don't get it, I ain't about that. Knock me down and watch me bounce back. You break your neck working for the cheese like that shit is sitting on a mousetrap. I'm just wanting it for that real shit. Every damn work in the building. I know you motherfuckers feel this. I am a legend like Will Smith, but ain't nobody really get that. I rip tracks, I don't look around, I sit back. Click back to the sound when the pen taps onto the paper, then I kill it like bang when I spit that. Leading them show for my lyrical madness. Working to put all the face in the casket. Fuck dreaming big, believe I'm dreaming massive. Mama told me if I work, I can have it. And I believe that shit, man, I'm not gonna lie, I believe that shit. Cause the more I be working on music, the more I can see that I don't really need that shit. I'm trying to build a grudge like bees in the beehive. This rap shit is in my jeans like Lexus and Levi's. They all be looking at me and making me feel bad. Looking like these bottles, these things I see, I start to smooth, so I put the brothers down. That's for Zax, man, it's funny cause I listen to him talk they shit. Mad at me because I'm grinding for my own sake. They ain't never had the drive to do all they can. Now I'm making more than them while they work all day shifts. Humbly speaking, I am a monster. Pushing for my dreams cause I see that I can conquer. Everything around me, they tell me I'm bound to prosper. So I feel the pressure but never will leave the roster. I'm
trying to build a buzz like bees in the beehive. This rap shit is in my jeans like Lexus and Levi's. They all be looking at me and they can't believe that. A youngin' like me is following his dreams when they see. I've been making the slightest moves, never been the brightest dude in school. But hit me and Mike and I bet I would do to you. That's real, I ain't playing with you, that's the truth.
I ain't playing, that's the Zax, man. I only speak the truth because that's all that I know. And that's what everybody hates, cause just about all of them know that they be wrong and I be right. It's just I'm not scared to show. And that's the difference between us, that's why you come and you go. And I'm the realest motherfucker that this game has ever seen. No, everybody watching me, plotting plans on the real low, trying to knock me down. If you do, I'ma reload. My rhymes are gold like the shit at the end of rainbows. I'm trying to get it, but I'm not trying to wait. I see them all pray, but nobody taking my place. They trying to blind me from my vision like spraying mace in my face. They see I'm about to feast and attack me when I'm saying my grace.
I know you fear them, they supreme like a hype. this close. That's a consequence of going friend or foe. Back to back hits like it's OVO. If I'm on a track, then you know it's dope. Bar for bar, I'm impeccable. To the point of precise like decimals. Not around the venue like Jordan. Just dropped a new colorway for retro foes. You think you big like these, but you metro built. You think you're somebody better, homie, you bet the bill. Now listen to me like a rep the field, and that's real. You should notice every time you probably get you killed. Stay back and sway, you become at the chest of meal. I shit on rappers with the remains of others I killed. Before your face back, looking like banana peels. I got a dark mind, homie, think I made it clear for real. Anytime I get a mic, I get a rapper. Say you heard him if you're talking like a burner. Probably innovate a murder out of service. If you wanted to this industry on purpose, when I started, I was nervous, but I'm breaking out of service now. It don't really matter what a motherfucker say. AK is a name in a booth, never played, never had, never did, never will, never quit. And I get what I give, but my shit, if you change up like a pitcher, do you keep pouring up like a pitcher, do now you wobbling around like a midget, do you say I'm fucked up, bitch? Look at you, I say fuck you and your whole crew. They said saying that would be a bold move, but you all fake it in tofu. Said I wouldn't do this, so I showed you, and I told you.
Styles of beyond. school shooting just occurred today. Figure what on earth can make somebody run up in a school where a church is taken. It's a lost weight missing a person's race. Those food kids trip with invertebrates. Fake rumors start to circulate. You beat his ass on camera cause they heard he's gay. The YouTube views almost over 30K. The internet got a soul shot low. We impersonate celebs. Nigga, let me y'all should be one. Not that we fail the world that need male role models. We should never rise, but he's gone. And mom don't keep up. She got two jobs. No life stress working for her children. She a worldwide teenage daughter in a room with a dude that's struggling while he's filming. Heard somebody feeling. Shit, all we do online is this and talk bad and we bash. Told the strangers, hopes and dangers. Glad to see my homies made it back from Iraq, but his sins are torn up. His friends got blown up. Enlisted as a kid ever since they grown up. They've been through so much, exposed to death and combat. How the fuck you come back and adapt? My homie just got hostage lymphoma. I'm praying every day, hoping he gon' beat it. Strong motherfucker on the phone would be telling me jokes while he was going through his chemo treatment. And he ain't put one side story on his timeline. Instagram and Facebook, they ain't always real life. People staring at their phones so much, they never get the look of a city skyline. Thinking that they Einstein, cause they wrote a clever post. It's just a flash in a tiny attention span. Music are chewed up like fast food is spewed out by the new with a menu plan. I can't hear shit. Every clear niggas die. My lyrics are merely a mess of the tears in my eyes. I've
done my best to share my life. My privacy's been sacrificed. But now we reach the end. Until we meet again. I put my soul in every word. I'll share my pain until it hurts. But now we reach the end. Until we meet again.
Open a checkpoint star this morning. Cop just shot and killed a black kid. It was all recorded. Just like the incident, they put it 2 days before it. This becomes the normal that a sick is beat. I know that I'm probably gonna piss some people off listening because I'm white and I'm talking about some shit we generally don't go through, but still I can't ignore it. So many people with power that won't go forward. The problem ain't gonna solve itself. Half of the cases are unreported. So what's calling on someone said when this is not a diss to all law enforcement. We calling them to help out when there's a threat. But I guess it's because I'm white. If I was black, I'd be scared to death. When David Banner asked where were all the white rappers at, when Mike Brown got gunned down, I couldn't think of any answers. I felt ashamed and afraid of the future with no contribution to any help with handling it. But I can't see the shooting videos from my last album and I can feel the tension. Another time in my life that I felt like I was guilty for the color of my skin tone. 3 months later, I was back in Missouri. The poor same night that the verdict is read. I was the shock on Twitter vent, and then when I'm a fan, tweeted it, Mike Brown deserved it. I said, man, you dumb as fuck. Imagine you went to the store for blunts to try to run out the door with a pack and the cops didn't bother arresting you. Would give you a lecture, but instead they just murdered you. Damn, this shit ain't right.
I've done my best to share my life. My privacy's been sacrificed, but now we reach the end. Until we meet again. I put my soul in every word. I'll share my pain until it hurts. But now we reach the end. Until we meet again. Oh yeah, yeah.
We hold these truths to be self-evident. All men are created equal. They're endowed by their creator with certain unalienable rights. And among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. That to secure these rights, governments are instituted among men, deriving their powers from the consent of the governed. All men are born free and equal, and have certain natural, essential, and unalienable rights, among which may be reckoned the right of enjoying and defending their lives and liberties. That of acquiring, possessing, and protecting their property, and find that of seeking and obtaining their safety and happiness. We've taken too many steps forward to take as many back.
Like
Why you trying to embarrass us? So I told that girl bye. I was stop on my stride. Rhymes kept getting better. My buzz is harder than I. Almost quitting when I did. Got introduced to the guy that put me on it. He been through the same struggle as I. The white rapper. Growing up, it was tough. My family set it us off. They gave up. I'm a just a white rapper. But I created the boss. Cause I'm boss in the booth. I grew up and I'm just a white rapper. But I'm ready to be dope. And I know that you think I'm a joke. Cause I'm just a white rapper. Put my heart on the stage, on the page. But at the end of the day, I'm still just a white rapper. Not a rap, give me a slutter with rappers. From every nationality, a ton of them crackers. The fact that I finally came up was miraculous. 20 years later, my name is becoming established. My album is on the rack at Best Buy. I was at the BET Awards, I was sitting right next to Luda and Rick Ross. But who would have thought I was just a Jimi Nicks flipping chicken.